covered everything. Starting to freeze. Going up in the Smoky Mountain, heading towards Spartanburg and Charlotte. Well, I got a little bit bigger car. Still got a sweet some snow. I just woke up. There's a pretty big hole there. Everything's frozen. It's like 18 degrees. I gotta warm my hands up. Well, made it to Bostic. The first crew change south of Kingsport. Too bad it was between 2 and 5 a.m. when I rode across the Smoky Mountains. That was always a pretty ride. Now I gotta make sure the line's clear. Switch hands. Well, I can hear him shoving cars. Oh, that was a wet ride, all that melting snow. Well, it wasn't melting last night. It was 18 degrees, but I stayed pretty warm in that sleeping bag. Constantly look behind me. Yard office is just right up here. Probably a bumpy walk. Yeah, they're getting a train ready here. This might be that Charlotte train. Put my camera away and find out. Alright, I just talked to the worker down there. And them cars right there are the ones I come in on, but they broke them up during the night. He says, where do you want to go? And I said, well, I kind of pushed it. I kind of overdid it a little. So I think I'm going to go back to Kingsport. And he says, well, that's track 3. He goes, walk to the end of that cut there. There'll be a gap. Which there is. He says, follow that gap down and you'll see another string of cars on track 3, which is them there. He says, them will go on to Kingsport. So, I'm marching my way down. Marching my way back to you, babe. Da 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 da. Yeah, so I gotta go down to. Yeah, I don't know. I think I overdid it again. I'm gonna have to start learning to regulate myself. I'm not 20 years old or 30 or 40 anymore. Plus all the medical issues. You know, back in the day, just 7-8 years ago, I could ride cross country in 3-4 days, no problem. No problem. Get off the train and jog 10 miles. Nope, not nowadays. All right, V's going to Kingsport. He said they're called for in about an hour. They'll come pick them up. So we'll get to go across the Great Smoky Mountains during the day. Carrying this bucket. Carrying my regular weight out of shape, too. Waiting around with them dumb doctors. Alright, you don't want to get on the last car that they're going to pick up. That's a no-no. Let me go ahead and put my camera up now that you got an idea of where I'm going. That way I have easier access to walk. Alright, found a ride. It's not Dirty Face either. The train will be going that way, so the non-windy side will be right here. Let's see if I can get up here. Gotta set the camera down. Gotta go in foot first. Got it. Not too dirty. Boy, perfectly hidden. Yeah, you got about 5 foot to stand up. And about 5.5 foot to roll out. That's why I brought my mat. And you can see plumb to the other side where I set my gear. Shall I get my mat out and roll it out and get comfortable for the ride? Yeah, I just didn't feel like... No, I don't want to get too far from home and have to end up getting sick somewhere, so... I'm going to have to take short trips and make them a little longer each time and see what my tolerance will do. Believe me, old, you guys getting older... You're one day going to go through this.
Well, we just hooked power up. I just felt the bang. Yeah, look here. You got another hole to set your feet in. Or if you got some stinky puppies. Just throw your shoes in there. But there's barely enough room for my mat in between there. Now we're not leaving. We're just pulling up to back down into another rack of cars. Got another little peak hole.
stuff in there. You can hear that bolt rail every 25 foot. You hear that clickety-clack. That's one of them high holes there. A little more room in there, you're a little better hid. I think we're gonna back down into them tank cars here. Well, I'm not gonna say exactly who. I'm definitely not gonna say who, but I was allowed to ride aboard. Let me shut this door. He looked inside that double barrel grainer I was on and he goes, "Oh my God, is that you, Shoestring?" I said, "Yeah. Man, I've been wanting to meet you for years. Give me a handshake." So he goes, "Man, there ain't no sense in you riding back here in that cold grainer. Come on, gather your stuff. You can ride that third power." So he come and opened the engine for me. And there's no cameras in this one. So this is gonna be a nice warm trip. Thank you, Lord. Oh my God. Thank you, Lord. And thank you, engineer, for letting me ride. Yeah, we're making it out of the yard now. for that other train. Getting over onto the main. Up into the mountains. Try to clean that window off. Head in view. Guys were nice enough to let me choose to ride up. Always love coming out of here. I'm not gonna say where. Give you a hint, it's close to Maryland. Not too much daylight left. Trying to make the most of it. One day I'm gonna show you what's in them engine compartments on the right. One's an electrical room, service rooms. But pretty soon we'll be getting up in the high elevation. A lot of shelling, a lot of track oilers. You know, the bucket buried in the ground I showed you. It's got the little pin that the wheel mashes down and it mashes a bead of oil on the track. A lot of them up here coming up. Well, this sure beats flying any day. An hour, it usually tells your train length to can't see, 6,599, I think. There's your heater control, air conditioner control. Your little empty fridge. And the bathroom. Yeah, I lost my cadet hat. Window a little. Dynamic brake. Taking the siding. Train in the side. Yeah. first of the mountains.
Thank you.
292 that we passed. Seems clear, more clear out of this window. Oh, it's a good 70 degrees on here. Well, last night there was 2 or 3 inches of snow on that grainer I had to ride on. So I rolled out my tarp, then rolled out my army mat, then rolled out my bedroll. And I only had about 3.5 foot to roll out straight. So my feet and legs from kneecap down were ice cold. And it got down to like 18 last night. My feet are still numb. They're not frostbit. I already looked at them, but came close. And I ran out of hand warmers and foot warmers. I thought I brought them all, but I guess not. Tunnel territory. this engine during Wyoming, that 80 mile an hour wind. Getting kind of late for foamers, rail fans, so I don't have to duck and cover every road crossing. Most of them are cool, but every now and then you'll get a rail fan that wants to try to get brownie points and tattletale on you. Oh my God, I just seen a hobo on one of your trains. Give me $5. Yeah, just call him a wiener schmitzel. Turkey and deer out there. That's one thing with my eyes being bad now. I miss seeing turkey. I miss seeing birds feed at my feeders, and I especially miss seeing stars. Probably miss seeing stars more than anything on Earth or off Earth. top speed we're gonna do. Got some hazmat stuff on here likely. There's an old abandoned rail. Tunnel country. Thank you. tearing the inside of that rail out in the flange of the wheels. Getting into mountain country now. Thank you. make this left-hand curve